and Vera immediately starts putting pressure on Aliakbari. Coming out of that southpaw stance, look for these big leg kicks that start to land. You can slow down that forward pressure that comes from Aliakbari. Aliakbari needs to wrestle. He needs to start getting close, utilize those hands to close that distance, get that body lock for those takedowns. But first, he's got to get through this defense of Brandon Vera. Look at these hands. The way he creates a moat around himself to prevent that body lock and those takedown attempts, that's going to be very important for Brandon Vera.
Brandon Vera, a background in kickboxing and Muay Thai. You're seeing the boxing early on here from the former heavyweight world champion. Overhand left there from Vera. That being the power hand. Aliakbari shot in for a single leg. Quickly escaped the counter punches from Brandon Vera. Jab there from Vera. Aliakbari's got to be careful on the takedown attempts. Got to be sharp. Can't be sloppy or Vera will make him pay.
Brandon Vera is coming into the first round. It looks like he's already sweaty. Like, so this is actually a really good strategy for him because it's going to be harder for Aliakbari to hold onto him if he comes into the match already sweaty. So probably a really good warm-up for Brandon Vera in the back.
Edging forward here, Vera. So many first-round finishes, especially off the hooking punches.
Aliakbari looks a little bit timid here in the stand-up. I didn't think he was expecting to see this aggressiveness coming from Brandon Vera this early.
Aggression and speed early on from Brandon Vera. Nice jab from Vera, threading it through the gloves. Wild hook there from Aliakbari.
Yeah, Aliakbari's got to be careful with those wild hooks. Brandon Vera's going to try to time that and come right down the middle. Oh, touched him on the chin there.
After a nice kick off the lead leg to the ribs there from Vera. Gloves up high on Aliakbari, palms turned out to try and catch those punches from the former world champion.
Some feints coming from Aliakbari.
Vera resets.
Biting on a few of them. I like how Brandon Vera's switching stances, giving Aliakbari different looks.
Good double jab from Vera. Vera fakes the cross. Nice switch up round kick. Aliakbari thinking. How does he get to the inside? Front kick off the back leg there from Vera. Aliakbari loads up the hammer off the left. Vera saw it coming. Back to center circle.
And he touched him on the top of the head with that left hand. Aliakbari looks a little bit leaner, Michael. He dropped about 4 kilos for this specific matchup because he wanted to add that speed. And he thought that would be a very important factor in this matchup.
Probing with the jab, Brandon Vera. Very patient fight from Aliakbari. Usually we see him come out flurrying. He's showing tremendous respect here to Vera.
There's a nice jab-hook combination landed by the former champion. Oh, there's a good entry into a takedown. Turns the corner.
This is where he wants to be, top position. Can he rain down the ground and pound? There's a heavy elbow. Another elbow. Another elbow. To the orbital. Oh, get this back. Brandon's in trouble. Brandon's in trouble.
Surfing away from that power side, immediately right down the middle with that right hand goes Aliakbari.
And Cerilli with the outside leg kick as they exchange in the center of the one circle, opening minute. 3 5-minute rounds. Heavyweights in the.
Ooh.
Big shot there from
Aliakbari. That one landed.
Charges in with the uppercut, and now they get into the clinch.
Oh, that was good. I like that. He hurt him. He got in there with the clinch and just kind of threatened that ability right there.
This is where Aliakbari needs to just stay patient on the inside, though, not waste too much energy trying to throw these knees and getting caught in this flurry of punches is going to drain his gas tank.
So really threw one of those leg kicks you talked about, Rich. I think he needs to keep going back to that just to sort of keep Aliakbari stationary so he can start putting his combinations together.
Yeah, you can see he's actually attacking not the thigh as you normally would, but down on the low calf. You can see the damage already on the outside of Akbari's calf.
Listen to the sound of these.
That's it. Aliakbari catches the leg kick, saw that one coming, gets into the clinch, has the back. Let's see what he does here.
Aliakbari's got him up against the fence, opening 2 minutes of this first round.
It was a smart strategy by Cerilli. Once the takedown was hit, he crawled his way over to the fence so he could use the fence to aid him on the get up.
Aliakbari needs to keep this nice and tight right now, utilize a little bit of the ground and pound. Cerilli's got to be careful. He needs to stay protected, keep his hands up. But he's also going to try to fight those hands to create a little bit of separation and spin and then go chest to chest. Because right now, this is what I was talking about, the grappling of Aliakbari. When we spoke about it on the walk, this is really where he excels. And we haven't seen this element of his game yet. And I think Cerilli might be a little bit surprised at just how well he's moving on the ground.
But I'll tell you, Aliakbari here, as he's punching, he can't forget the pedigree that he has in wrestling. Make sure he maintains that topside pressure so he doesn't have to deal with these scrambles with Cerilli all the time. You know, maintain that position. Choose your strikes intelligently. He can make quick work of this fight tonight if he does so.
Yeah, this is a draining position right now for Cerilli. You know, Aliakbari is used to these sort of riding positions where he can just get on top of people, lean on them, make him carry his weight, and also dropping a little bit of that ground and pound. This is a good first 5 minutes right here for Aliakbari.
He's been the aggressor, already a couple of takedowns. Cerilli has been on the defense in the opening 3 minutes. First of 3 5-minute rounds in the heavyweight division to kick off the main card here on One Prime Video One.
Yeah, these are nice little off-balancing techniques.
Aliakbari firing rights to the face of Cerilli. Cerilli trying to get away. He's in defense mode here.
Oh, side control right now. He's got to be careful right here. There's a ground and pound position for Aliakbari.
A couple of heavy elbows to the face from Amir Aliakbari, the man from Iran.
You can see he's trying to push down on the legs, looking to maybe go into mount right here. I'd like to see Cerilli get the underhook with his right arm and come underneath the arm of Aliakbari, but right now he's going to get crucifixed and just walk into this position right here.
This is a bad position with somebody like Aliakbari on top of you. He's unable to defend himself here.
Ground and pound.
Cerilli's trying to bench press Aliakbari off of him right now.
Elbows to the face. Cerilli is eating a lot of these from Aliakbari. Now the hammer fist from Amir Aliakbari, throwing shots, and Cerilli's eating it.
Man, in 55 seconds in this
Americana,
round.
Americana, rather, right there on that far side
arm. Herb Dean taking a close look here. Cerilli in a tough spot.
Good job by Cerilli to defend the submission attempt there from Aliakbari. This is really where Aliakbari has to start raining down those shots. He can get a stoppage win right here if he can stop the scrambling and really start to unload.
Throwing him to the right side of the face, and you can see the damage to the face of Cerilli. This is going to be a long final 25 seconds for Cerilli.
Yeah, Herb Dean's giving him the benefit of the doubt, allowing him to work. But Cerilli ain't going anywhere. He has to free one of these arms to try to scramble out.
Yeah, he's still technically moving and defending himself in a sense, but he's defenseless because he can't get his guard up to stop these elbows.
Good bloody face.
Look at the knee position of Aliakbari. He's pinning his knee right up against the hip of Cerilli, so Cerilli can't get out, but he allowed him to get out.
But I would have to expect that Cerilli's camp knew that they were going to have some sort of storm the weather in the first round with somebody like Aliakbari, especially if they ended up on the ground.
I mean, Aliakbari in his entire career has only been out of the first round 3 times, so this is not uncharted water, but he's used to getting things done in the first five. He knocks out his mouthpiece. Cerilli comes forward.
Mouthpiece out. Cerilli attacking back. Both men swinging wildly. Big left hook there. And now Herb Dean going to break him up and allow Aliakbari to pull his mouthpiece off the canvas.
Although Cerilli landed that overhand right there, he needs to come in with a more calculated approach, not get too excited. I think there's another one, too. And if he just stays patient, he's going to continue landing those things.
A couple of overhand rights with power from Cerilli.
Cerilli actually looks a little bit fresher than Aliakbari. Aliakbari is not moving well. He's not stepping out of the way with the same sort of gust and vigor that he had in the first one, so he has to really start to dig deep as well.
When you go back at the end of the first round, Mitch, look at Aliakbari walking to his stool. You can see him get up off the top of Cerilli and take this deep breath. And that exchange, even though he was in control, took it out of him as well.
Cerilli into the tank. Well, a single, you're right. Now he's in half guard.
That was just a bull rush. He just grabbed onto the leg. Just
whatever was there, man.
But I'll tell you, that's a bit of fatigue on Cerelli's side, because we saw Arjun Buller trying those single leg attempts, and he did a great job of defending those attempts with him.
Yes, he did. Now Aliakbari is inside, or half guard rather, and this is a really good position for ground and pound. You can see Aliakbari is trying to control the position. Now it's really important that Cerilli gets his back off of the mat. He needs to try to dig an underhook, get onto his side, and then start moving around. Because right now, you can see that Aliakbari is trying to push down on the thigh so he can slide his right leg through and get into full mount. But half guard is a great position for him. He can do a lot of damage from right here.
Yeah, he's hanging on the back of the head with his left arm there, and he should be digging that under the armpit right there so that he can get this control. But he's done it too late now, and Aliakbari is coming for the Kimura. Exactly.
Shots to the body as well, being poured in by Aliakbari. How taxing is the fact that Cerilli has been in this position for much of this fight so far?
Well, it's extremely taxing, you know, especially when you're dealing with a grappler such as Aliakbari, who's been grappling pretty much his entire life inside the wrestling circuit. So it's really important that, you know, Cerilli stays composed here. He doesn't make any mistakes. He finds his opening. He gets the underhook and gets off his back, because right now, Aliakbari is just dropping those elbows right on him.
And you can see Cerilli's left hand on the back of Aliakbari's head. He's actually pulling him down into the half guard, just making the position tighter. Like, it's just worsening the position for Cerilli.
Yeah, Cerilli's got to take his left arm and dig underneath the right arm of Aliakbari. Look at Aliakbari, pins the arm down. Now he's in a great position for ground and pound.
Pounding with that left, some elbows, and now throwing fists into the face. Nothing that Cerilli can do at this point with 120 left in the second round.
That's just great hip pressure from Aliakbari right there, not getting too greedy with those punches. Little punches, not trying to knock him out with a single punch, but knowing that these punches and bunches, the short little elbows, they're going to open him up, and that's what's eventually going to score all this damage for him.
Great control from Aliakbari right here. Look at him framing off the face, sliding the elbow straight down, and just like that, it's over.